Well, the Bemidji Woolen Mills have been a part of this Bemidji city history for 100 years as of this month. Betsy Moline has more in this week's business report.
There's local history everywhere you look at the Bemidji Woolen Mills, from the origin of the iconic Paul and Babe statue to a look back at each year of the water carnival. If you stop in on a day that fourth generation owner Bill Batchelder is in, he will be more than happy to show you around and share the stories. This month marks 100 years for the company.
Woolen Mills turned 100 years old on October 9th, and it's been an incredible milestone for Bemidji Woolen Mills, our employees, our customers, our family. It's just been the magnitude of being in business 100 years.
Although the company is 100 years old, the Irving Street storefront is actually the second location for the business. It was purchased in 1929, following the building going into bankruptcy during the Great Depression.
It was, believe it or not, Bemidji's first livery stable, and then it turned into the Bemidji Chevrolet Garage, and then that folded during the Great Depression. Building became available, and against nearly everybody's odds, our family purchased the building, and here we are today in 2020.
Although much has changed in the past 100 years, one constant are the loyal customers who keep coming back one generation to the next.
This summer, for the first time, we've actually had sixth generation summer family residences bringing their babies in here. When their great-great-grandfather came up here at the turn of the century.
Those repeat customers keep the woolen mill alive in the hard times. When faced with difficulty, Bill has turned to the advice of his father.
He goes, "Thank God that we have the staying power. We have the repeat customers that will always support you. Just hang on to the wheel a little bit tighter, and you will get through the difficult downturns. And then you'll celebrate in the better years."
Bill is passionate about highlighting local artisans and products within the store. He hopes in the future to continue to include more locally made items. Reporting in Bemidji for this week's In Business, Betsy Moline, Lakeland News.
Certainly a Bemidji tradition, no doubt about that.
Lakeland News is member-supported content. Please consider supporting Lakeland News today.